What if you could make with AI an avatar of yourself so easily and so beautifully that you couldn't tell if it's a real person or not? We're going to do that next on the Cozy AI Kitchen. Welcome to this special episode of the Cozy AI Kitchen, where we're working with avatars. You know, avatars, this sort of these computer graphics, faces that can talk in realistic ways and you can talk back to them, etc. Well, we have the chef who is creating this wave of AI avatars himself, Cenyu Zhang. Welcome, Cenyu Zhang. How are you doing, Cenyu?
Yeah, very good. How are you, John?
Well, you know, I'm so excited because I've seen your work, and maybe if you can say a few sentences about your work.
Absolutely. I mean, it's really excited to be here. So my name is Cenyu. I'm a product manager from Azure AI. So I drive the adoption of multimodal AI services and also some of the emerging AI services like TTS Avatar.
And multimodal, can you explain what that is for the audience?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you look at the LLM, usually it's based on text. And now we have the capability to add images, videos, and audios to those larger language models. So that's what we call the multimodal.
And you're going to be cooking multimodal avatars, is that correct, with AI?
Yeah, so multimodal is going to be the backend for a digital avatar. So avatar is the digital human as the front end. It'll be using the output from those multimodal large language models and then present to you as the user.
Okay, well, Chef Cenyu, please go ahead and cook this meal.
Absolutely. So first, I'm going to show you what is our thinking, right? So how we design the service. So we call the text-to-speech avatar. So a couple of years ago, when we started sitting on the table, right? So how we can design the avatar service? There are many ways to design the service. The first one is we could make like a cartoon type of avatar, which is already available through Microsoft Mesh technology. And then we also could make the 3D, the meta-human. Some of them will be cartoon type, and some of them will be real human. And then also we can make a two-dimensional photorealistic avatar. So after a lot of discussion, we decided let's go to the two-dimensional real human photorealistic avatar first. And so this is basically our offering. I mean, our offering is both the pre-built avatars and also the custom avatar. The pre-built, we have a pretty wide selection of like about 20 avatars you can choose from, and also like a good selection of both genders, male and females. And for the custom avatar, this is where it's going to get fun. So you can basically create your own avatar, providing maybe like a 5 minutes or 10 minutes of video of yourself, and then we can create that custom avatar for you. And there are a lot of use cases you can use the avatar. I mean, for example, the real-time chatbot for customer service or training videos or town hall, like streaming. So all those are the use cases you can utilize.
And you're using the power of Azure AI to do all this. I can't wait.
Yeah, absolutely. So let me switch to do some demos. So awesome. This will be fun. So here you can see I'm in the AI speech studio. So in the future, you will go to the AI studio. That will be there. I mean, it's like after a couple months. So here you can see we have a lot of different functionality from our Azure speech services. Let me scroll down to the very bottom. This is called the text-to-speech avatar. So once I click it, you can see there are a lot of avatars on the right-hand side you can choose from. So I'm just going to choose one of the avatar called Lisa Grace for City. So this is one of our early avatars we created. Over the past couple of months, we added so many different pre-built avatars. And we built this UI that you can easily just type the sentences you want the avatar to speak. And then also you can choose the language, what language you want the avatar to speak, as well as what kind of voice. So now let's do something simple. We'll say, hi, my name is Lisa, right? How are you today? Thank you for watching the Cozy AI Kitchen show. Let me click a preview video. So after about like maybe a 10 second or so, the avatar video will be ready, and then we can play it.
Oh, you're sort of in the oven right now, cooking.
Oh, very good. So, so now the avatar video is ready. So let me play the video.
Hi, my name is Lisa. How are you today? Thank you for watching the Cozy AI Kitchen show.
All right, so you can see, you can hear Lisa just spoke, right, in English. Because this is the voice we have selected, this is multilingual voice. So what if I switch to Spanish or maybe Japanese? Let's see what the avatar will be able to speak. So I already have it ready. So this is like another avatar we have. Here is basically Spanish. We want the avatar to speak with the same voice, but this is the multilingual voice. So the beauty here is that it can automatically recognize the language, right? Mm. And then speak for that language. So let me just play this one.
Hola, mi nombre es Lisa. ¿Cómo estás hoy? Gracias por ver el programa Cozy AI Kitchen.
Yeah, so it's basically the same greetings that Lisa said in English. We can also try another preview avatar we have. Huh. Here is basically Japanese. So basically, the same thing. Let's see what now his name is David, so not Lisa anymore.
こんにちは。私の名前はデイビッドです。今日はお元気ですか? Cozy AI Kitchen 番組をご覧いただきありがとうございます。
Yeah, so John, I mean, I do not understand Japanese.
It was perfect.
So,
it was perfect.
Okay, very good. So, John, do you have any questions? If not, I mean, I can take you to the real-time avatar and then see how it works. So this is what we call the batch mode. Batch mode means you do this offline, and then you can actually save the video to export the video. So here's a button we allow you to export the video. So here you can see you can enter the name and then wow. also the formats, MP4, movie, WebM. And then once you click the terms and conditions, you can just export the video. Another thing is, once you export the video, you may want to add the background, because right now the background is just white, right? So you can add like an image or like a video to the background. In order to do that, we recommend that you choose the transparent background. And then once you download the video, you can use another tool like ClickChamp to do some video editing.
Wow. So then you're saying that I don't have to be here as in the Cozy AI Kitchen and make an avatar of myself with the apron, and I can outsource myself, are you saying?
Yeah, that might be the future one day. So
very cool.
Yeah, so now, John, so let me take you to the real-time avatar picture we have. Mm. This is the live chat avatar. Also on the speech studio, and also in the future will be on the AI studio.
Wow.
Here, let me come here, and now it's loading the avatar. And then we actually build a UI here that you can select the multi-language. I'm going to switch on the multi-language. Here you can see there are some of the languages already selected. Let's also make sure that we select Japanese. Here it's basically using the Aver multilingual voice so that we can speak like different languages, and we don't have to tell the avatar what language we're speaking. Let's also choose a different avatar here. Let's choose Lori, we will save the changes. As the avatar is loading, John, you can see here, there's a model. This is the GPT-4o model, the latest multi-model from Azure OpenAI, right? So we built this as a demo you can use. So behind the scene, the avatar is actually interacting with the GPT-4o model and getting the answers, and then presents through the avatar. Of course, you can change to other models we have, for example, the 5.3 model as well.
So you can also use a small language model too.
Absolutely, wow. absolutely. All right, so now you see Lori's ready to talk. So let's see what we're going to talk to Lori about. Hey, good morning. How are you today?
I'm just a program, so I don't have feelings, but I'm ready and equipped to help you. How can I assist you today?
What is Microsoft TTS Avatar Service?
The Microsoft TTS, text-to-speech, avatar service is a technology that integrates text-to-speech capabilities with animated avatars to provide a more engaging and interactive user experience. It allows developers to create applications where a virtual character can speak text in a natural-sounding voice, synchronized with corresponding facial expressions and lip movements.
Yeah, so you can see the avatar actually was able to find the information about our TTS avatar service through the GPT-4 model. Since the response is too long, so we're just stopping here. So let's ask another question. Who is John Maeda?
John Maeda is a renowned designer, technologist, and author recognized for his influential work at the intersection of design, technology, and business.
So John, is that right?
Well, I'm glad I didn't say that I robbed a bank in Ontario last year. So that's a sign of good guardrails and good grounding. Wow. So Chef Cenyu, this has been amazing to see. And I know in the multimodal space, it's so important to demonstrate this kind of a technology. Sort of, can you share with the audience your perspective on where this world of AI avatars is heading as a leading technologist of this new wave?
Yeah, absolutely. So last year, right? So for the past 2 years, the LLM, large language model, has gained a lot of interest and also usage with the users. But I mean, so people are starting to ask. I mean, it's only text, right? What if I mean, so I can interact with the large language model using images, audios, and videos, right? So that is already available through our GPT-4 model. And then this is basically part of the journey. And then user, sometimes they prefer to have a human interface to talk to, right? So this is basically our TTS Avatar service. Will come in, basically serving as a human interface, right, to talk to you as the user. So I see this is like a definitely the trend, and also even going forward, right. So there could be embodied like agents in the future as well. So this is what I see as the future. This is very exciting. Oh, by the way, John, I actually. Forgot to demonstrate the multilingual capabilities of the avatar. So just now we're able to speak English. Maybe we can switch to Japanese or Chinese and see what the avatar can answer. O genki desu ka? O ne mai wa?
Watashi wa genki desu. Arigatou gozaimasu. Watashi wa tokutei no namae o motte inai AI asistanto desu ga, nani ka o tetsudai dekiru koto ga areba douzo oshirase kudasai.
Yeah, so John, because I don't speak a lot of Japanese, so I'm not sure if the answer is good enough.
Well, they said basically that I'm an AI and I don't have a name. And so it was basically giving that kind of a responsible AI response like it should. Well, Chef Cenyu, thank you for this demonstration of this amazing technology. I think maybe in the future I may show up as one of your avatars. So thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, John.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.